What's up, guys? I'm here with a tutorial. It might be a bit strange, because I don't usually do tutorials, but hey ho. It's a FL Studio tutorial on Big Room House, which I've seen a lot of, and some of the tutorials aren't quite informing, as it were. It's not like telling you exactly how to make it, so I'll show you a few examples. I think this is loud enough. Garrix, he is very popular at the moment because of his song Animals, which you may have heard. It's here on the side, and but I prefer this one because it's a bit more creative. It's got his sound, but it's I like the melody and the lead, whatever you want to call it, and the drop's quite creative. Here we have a Blasterjaxx 15. This is the Hardwell edit, and I'm not sure what the difference is between the original and Hardwell edit, but I think the second drop's slightly different, but I think it's mainly for popularity towards the song, so I'm going to play that.
Drop 15 in the DMC.
Right, I don't want to get done for copyright or anything, so I'm only playing you a bit of that one. Martin Garrix, I suppose he's not, the spin-in isn't too bothered about that one, but I know that Revealed are quite tight with their copyright infringement, so I'm not going to play too much of that. What I'm going to do is I'm going to show you, oh no, not responding, oh well, I know, yeah, it's responding. I'm going to do like a sort of melody from the Martin Garrix song and a drop from the Blasterjaxx song. So if I open up, yeah, bye. If I open up FL, it should work. I'm hoping it's going to work. I hope you can hear. If not, I'll have to redo it, and I really don't want to. First, you want to set it to 128. Some people do it 130, but really, it's your preference, I suppose. Personally, I prefer 128, it's a bit more bouncy. The swing, I don't think we're going to bother with the swing today, so I think we're just going to start with a melody and not bother with an intro. So I'm going to get silent up, and I'm going to need to find a good preset to use. Yeah, I think we use that. I'm not sure what this bank is, the Umez O'Khan or whatever his name is. Oh wait, I need to change the driver, sorry about that. Because it's messed up, the drivers. Oh no, I might have some latency here. We'll have to see. Oh, that's 2D tuned. There's a lot of odd sounds. Yeah, I think we're gonna have that in the drop. Actually, that might sound quite nice. In fact, I might use the standard Big Fifth preset. I think anyone who's familiar with Big Room will know that this is Hardwell's signature sound it uses it's actually just on the factory bank. So you have to take it off this setting here of +7th, because it makes every note you play in 7th chord, and it's not exactly the greatest if you want to keep the notation the same, the key the same as the rest of the song. And I think I'm going really lengthy on this tutorial, but I'm not bothered. You know, fuck the system. Been a while, as you can probably tell. Bad latency. Can see what I'm doing here. I'm going to have the chords playing underneath the actual melody on top, which I know this isn't Martin Garrix's style, and I've probably led you on a bit too much there with the way I've told you how I'm going to do it, but this is also going up like this. I think Dimitri Vegas and Like Mike use it, I think, if I remember correctly. I'm gonna bring this down. Jesus Christ almighty, that didn't sound too good. Parametric EQ, take the low end off a bit because it's quite, and sort of do this slant, but like a mountain range. I'm not very technical with it. I just put the drive off and take the sustain and release down a bit. Okay, right. I've thought what I'm gonna do. What you wanna do here is you wanna just fiddle around with this a bit. Fiddle around with that, click tools, last tweaked, and then create automation clip, and just basically the last thing knob you've turned is gonna become an automation clip when you do that. So check this. had an impact here. And then a slightly less heavy impact there. And add in the 4x4 clap. 4x4, that's a bloody car, what the fuck am I on about? Not even have that one. The 4 to the floor clap, that's what it's called. Fuck it though. You can tell I'm ill. I'm not with it. Back down again on the last bit here, and then you want to just minimize that too. So I've dum dum, you want to have it going dum 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 dum. So, oh wait, you want to have it doing that. You want to add a build up now, so I think I might put that here. Just and I've actually got this big room pack bundle thing with loads of awesome loops in it. I don't use the loops much because I'm a very strong believer in using maybe just samples and your own sounds. But for this purpose, I think I might use. Yeah. I'm gonna use this for the purpose of the tutorial because it's dragging on too long and it would be a whole different thing if I had to make that from scratch. So now we're gonna go into this. Drop first, simply for the reason that if I get like the basic rhythm for this bit, it makes it easier for me to add the snare in with the same pattern, so the drop's a bit more smooth. So where am I? I need a hard bass drum. Now this is an absolute nightmare. You have to tune the kick because listen, got real heavy bass underneath it, tone bass. So if we listen, I'm gonna have to. Basically, how you change the pitch is just with this thing here, and what it will do is it'll just change the pitch, and then it stays in the same. We'll be right back. But we're too high with the bass drum, so I might have to. In fact, that sounds pretty sick. I'm not gonna lie, it sounds good like that. So, because this drags over, I need to pull that back. For some reason, that's there. But so we've got that kick, but we have to layer the kicks to create the side chain. Now this is like the main kick that Hardwell uses. It's not EQ'd yet, so it sounds a bit different. But once we EQ it and we sidechain it, when layered with other sounds, it gives it this real thumpy sound. Oh, I'm not yet. In number one, so we're gonna sidechain that now and EQ it a bit, take away the low end, boost the high end, maybe a bit there, and then limiter. I think everyone that knows FL Studio knows how to do this. Add an extra awesome tip for you guys. Actually, I've just realised I've completely forgot about this. I'll just show you now. One second. We need to add a wind in here, because what Blasterjaxx and Martin Garrix actually do a lot is they have a. They have like a break in the build before the drop to give emphasis. And what we can do there is we can add a vocal clip, if I can do this correctly. And what I, instead of actually like downloading someone else's clip, I'll show you now on the website. Just type in text to speech and go to this AT&T Natural Voices website. And I use Rich. And I just like, if we think about it, you have to find syllables that will work with the computerized voice. So, and also you have to do you have to write it in the way that they would say it. So pseudonym wouldn't work as a word, just picking a random word, because of the way it's spelled, you'd have to write it the way it sounds. So if I think about something, I'm just gonna do like drop the huge sound. Ooh. Drop the huge sound, and we can stretch that out. We just save that. Drag this into the thing.
Drop the huge sound.
So if we just assign this, we can not peak controller, parametric EQ. We boost that, give the voice some clarity, put some reverb on it. It's supposed to sound computerized as well.
Drop the huge sound. Drop the huge sound. Drop the.
Oh, and a bit of a we'll try different. Let me think of a quote or something. In fact, it took. That's just a demonstration. I'm just gonna actually just use the. Everywhere, jump quotes. If I can find it. I apologize. I might have to skip edit this bit out. Fuck off. Hate all these things. Is it downloaded? Yep, doing that. In here, hopefully it's the right thing. If it's like a full song, I'm gonna be pretty annoyed because I want to get this tutorial over and done with because I'm not feeling too well. As you can probably, yep, this is a full song. I can probably sample it.
No precious time.
This is the Temper Trap song, isn't it? This is a full bloody mix that's downloaded, like, oh no, it isn't. I'll find it, don't worry. Eventually, don't trust index of MP3s next time. Fucking hell. Anyways, everybody, jump voice sample. Yeah, exactly. Right. This Orion ends dive watches tutorials. Big up to him, he's proper. What's this? Is this it? Yeah, I'm not quite sure what the hell that is. Yeah, I'm gonna stick with where is it?
Booyah!
Fast beat, go! Sample, which if you don't know, is from Noro Milani Atom, one of the biggest tracks I've ever heard in my life. Check it out.
Fast beat, go!
Yeah, that works. It works pretty well, actually. And now you want to add a snare that's rolling. Like, pick a reasonably snappy snare. If you want to be cheeky, press swap stereo, it gives it a slightly different sound. You want to create automation clip for the volume, bring it down here, up to where it should be, or just below, wherever you really want it to. It's just all about personal preference in my opinion. To be extra, I don't know, professional, just turn this up to 48, create automation for the pitch, and just put this up slightly. And now we're going to copy the drop and we're going to put it into a different snare sound. It's all about the layers, in my opinion. It just adds the depth to the song and makes the drop seem bigger, I suppose. In fact, this might need duplicating and putting it over there. For the little touches, so a ride cymbal for the second part of the drop always goes down well in my book. Adds just a bit of variation to the drop. I'm going to take the out down so it doesn't ring as much around your ears. You want to EQ it as well, because ride cymbals seem to overpower in the mix when they're not EQ'd for some reason. Well, for me they do. I think I've got some weird ride cymbals. And to be even more pro, you can clone it, reverse it, put it back to normal. Wait, we might have to go one before. So it reverses. It gives a really swingy feel to it without actually using the swing counter, which is always good. If you want to add some toms as well, always good to have a bit of tomage. So I'm not sure, is it, if it's two then it's going to be four, isn't it? Yeah. And also all the way through the, oh yeah, we've got the rides, haven't we? All the way through the song, what you want to do is you want to, not all the way, the drop mainly, you want to have these sounds. If you recognize them from animals, he uses them to variate the drop. So like say every time, wait, do we put it there? Like before the next bar starts, so you'll see what I switch the sample to Pro Transient, because then it stays in the same range. You might want to take the out down on that as well, because it's quite aggressive. Maybe add a bit of reverb just to spice it up. But put it up low cut, take the size down, take the differ down if you want to add like a ringing effect to it, and put the delay up and just It means after the snare has sounded, like a, how many milliseconds is that? Let me see. 270 was the one I was at. So 270 milliseconds after the sound is finished, the Arriva tail comes in, so it even more variation, I suppose. And if you want to be even more pro, I mean, I'm totally revealing so many secrets to you right now, my production secrets, to be honest. Anyway, so you can add this in. You can add in the, like, the end of the melody, lead, whatever, in a part of the drop to add. This isn't properly mastered or anything, but I'm just gonna quickly. You can see it's peaking, so we might have to bring that down. And I do have this, but it's not perfect. But it's here because it keeps putting silence into the song because I don't think I've authorized it. You wanna, in fact, cut it off there, like so. I still don't know the musical term. And what I was always taught to do is to add a U shape. Into the mix, quite symmetrical, to master it, I suppose. And compression, I have no idea what to do, so I just use the multibrand compressor and I press mastering 2.4 decibels and bring the volume down a bit more. And that's pretty much it, really. The melody might need changing a bit. So, yeah, the melody might need changing if I'm ever actually going to release this song. But that's my Big Room tutorial. I'm going to play through the entire thing now. Oops, sorry. Ugh, I'm not feeling too good. Yeah, drop a like rating or whatever the hell you want to do. Like, rate, and subscribe, you know. So, yeah, here it is. That was it. Cheers, guys.